Hello everyone, welcome you all in today's lecture. Today's topic is mechanical ventilation, common terminology and fundamentals of mechanical breath. I am Dr. Mohammad Nurul Akhtar Hassan, pediatric intensivist and associate professor, pediatric intensive care, National Heart Foundation Hospital and Research Institute, Dhaka, Bangladesh. At the end of this lecture, you will be able to understand common terminology used in mechanical ventilation and fundamentals of mechanical breath. So here are the few definitions. First is tidal volume. It is the volume of gas that flows in and out of the chest during quiet breathing. It is usually 6 to 10 ml per kg. Then rate or frequency. It is the rate of mechanical breaths per minute. In different brand of ventilator, you will find it in different name, either rate or frequency. Minute ventilation is the product of tidal volume and respiratory rate, expressed in liter per minute. It is the total ventilation per minute. Usually, we don't provide this in ventilator directly or manipulate directly. When we set tidal volume and rate, it will get calculated automatically. Then is inspiratory time and inspiratory expiratory ratio. Inspiratory time, TI or I time, is the amount of time delegated to inspiration. Inspiratory expiratory ratio is usually 1:1.5 to 1:3. But out of this range is sometimes used according to patient's condition. Less than 1:1.5, 1:1 is sometimes used in small neonates, premature neonates, and ARDS. And even inverse ratio, like 2:1, is also used in ARDS patients. Ratio more than 1:3 is used in ARA, hyperreactive ARA, like asthma. Adjustment of inspiratory time is the primary method by which the inspiratory expiratory ratio is altered. When we set respiratory rate and inspiratory time, inspiratory expiratory ratio is set automatically. On the other hand, when we set rate and inspiratory expiratory ratio, inspiratory time automatically get set. Normal inspiratory time range from 0.3 to 2 seconds, depending on patient's age, ventilatory rate, and underlying lung conditions. There is no hard and fast rule, but this can be an initial setup. In premature neonate, 0.3 to 0.5 second, young infant 0.6 to 0.7 second, older infant 0.7 to 0.8 second, toddler 0.8 to 1 second. In children more than 5 years, 1 to 1.2, and even older children 1.2 to 1.4 second, and in adult 1.5 to 2 second. Sensitivity or trigger. This is the ventilator's ability to understand the patient's demand for a breath to initiate a mechanical breath. We shall see a little detail in subsequent slides. Peak inspiratory pressure, PIP or PP. It is the maximum pressure measured by the ventilator during inspiration. Positive end expiratory pressure, PWP, it is the pressure in the airway at the end of inspiration. This pressure is very important to prevent lung atelectasis and to help in lung recruitment and to maintain a functional residual capacity. Mean airway pressure, it is a ventilator setting, but we don't set this thing. It is determined by several factors including PIP, PWP, inspiratory time and flow rate. So machine usually calculate this according to PIP, PWP, inspiratory time and flow rate setting. Continuous positive airway pressure. Amount of pressure applied to airway during all phases of respiratory cycle. This is somehow synonymous to PWP or positive end expiratory pressure. Pressure support is the amount of pressure applied to airway during spontaneous inspiration by patient in SIMV mode or pressure support mode or CPAP plus pressure support mode of ventilation. We shall see this in subsequent lectures. This is a very important slide. Four basic parameters determining mechanical bed. We have subsequent lectures on it in detail. Today, we shall discuss briefly about these four parameters. First is triggering is the initiation of a mechanical breath. How the mechanical breath will be initiated for a patient. Whether it will be initiated by ventilator or it will be initiated by patient. If it is initiated by ventilator, then it is machine trigger or time trigger. Or if it is initiated by patient, then it is patient trigger, which can be further flow trigger, pressure trigger or electrical activity of diaphragm. Then is the flow. This is the pattern of inspiratory flow, how the lung will get air from the ventilator, how much the flow will be and what will be the pattern of flow, whether it will be constant flow during the whole inspiratory time or a decelerating flow. Then is limiting the breath. It is the mechanism of limiting the breath or size of the breath. It means how much the lung will be expanded during inspiration to a certain volume or to a certain pressure. And finally, cycle. Cycle is the termination of breath. How the inspiration will be terminated. Will it be terminated after a certain period of time or will it be terminated after delivering a certain amount of flow? Now comes to negative pressure and positive pressure ventilation. When we talk about mechanical ventilation, we actually discuss about positive pressure ventilation, which we usually use in day-to-day practice in our ICU. But the mechanical ventilation started with negative pressure ventilation during polio epidemics in early 50s. In negative pressure ventilation, atmospheric pressure, say here atmospheric pressure is zero and intraalveolar pressure is also zero and patient is not taking any breath. In negative pressure ventilation, the atmospheric pressure is made negative by a chamber around the body or a chamber or a jacket around a thoracic cavity, which causes outward movement of thoracic case and negative intraalveolar pressure, which draws air inside the lung. On the other hand, in positive pressure ventilation, atmospheric pressure is not changed. Ventilator provides respiration inside the lung with a force. So in negative pressure ventilation, pressure lower than atmospheric pressure is applied to the extrathoracic space. On the other hand, pressure higher than atmospheric pressure is applied to the intraalveolar space in positive pressure ventilation. During inspiration, ventilator provides gas inside the lung with positive pressure. When inspiration ends, ventilator stop providing air and exhalation valve get opened and then air comes out of the lung automatically and passively and expiration started. So expiration is a passive process. Finally, positive pressure ventilation, there are two general methods, volume limit ventilation or pressure limit ventilation. In volume limit ventilation, lung is inflated with a preselected volume or tidal volume. But what would be the pressure inside the lung? That is not under control of ventilator. That depends on patient's lung condition. If patient's lung is not good, if there is atelectasis, pneumonia, consolidation, then intraalveolar pressure would be high. On the other hand, in pressure limit ventilation, inflation pressure or P-peak is preselected. But how much the amount of tidal volume will be delivered inside the lung is not fixed. So, inflation volume may vary according to patient's lung condition. So, there are different types of breath in mechanical ventilation. In controlled breath is not triggered by patient. There is no control on patient. Controlled breath will be delivered by ventilator and it is time trigger and full support will be provided by mechanical ventilator. But in assisted breath, patient will trigger a breath and that can be flow or pressure trigger. And full or partial support will be provided according to mode used. In pressure support, when breath again is patient triggered and partial support will be provided to patient in pressure supported breath. And in spontaneous breath, that is non-triggered, patient is taking spontaneous breath and no support will be provided. We have discussed today regarding initial ideas, terms and fundamentals of mechanical breath. Hope you understood. Thank you all. During next lecture, we shall discuss four basic parameters determining mechanical breath, trigger, flow, limit, and cycle. If you find this lecture helpful, please give a thumbs up and subscribe the channel.